bring out the blue corner, Milan Zerjal.
Man, you are in for a treat watching this kid fight. Milan Zerjal, now he's been out of the tough enough cage for a long time by Milan Zerjal standards. He has not fought since last month, like 3.5 weeks ago. Yep. Why is that so crazy, John?
That is a long layup for Milan Zerjal because he took that fight on 1 week's notice after fighting 1 week prior. So the guy finishes up with a fight, gets a phone call and says, yeah, I'm good, let's do it.
So here he is about 3.5 weeks later, Milan Zerjal stepping back into the tough enough cage, and he lost his last fight. It was a very close fight that he had and wildly entertaining. This guy can stand in there, take some punches, and throw right back. I cannot tell you how excited I am to see Milan Zerjal fight again. If you would just please refrain from bleeding all over us this time.
Yes, I did have to take the suit to the dry cleaners right after that. I'll be honest, it was an entertaining fight. For those that know that tuned in our last show in February, an absolute barn burner. He's very tough on the feet, crisp Muay Thai. He's well-versed on the ground as well. Trains with Robert Drysdale and the Hyena. So he's got, you know, well-rounded skills and just super aggressive at all times, super durable. Just a pleasure to watch.
Gonna be a good one tonight. Milan Zerjal, always good to see him inside the tough enough cage. Let's meet his opponent.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the sixth fight of the evening in the welterweight division. Introducing first in the blue corner, with one win and one loss, fighting out of Drysdale Hyena, Las Vegas, Nevada, here is Milan Zerjal. Let's bring out the red corner, Justin Calhoun.
Justin Calhoun, 34 years old, making his debut as an amateur mixed martial artist. Stands 5'11", 170 pounds. He has been training in mixed martial arts since 2008, and about 3 years later decided, you know what, it's time. I'm gonna make the debut. I applaud him, he's 34 years old. I would say that now would be the time to do it. If you're gonna do it, get in there, see what you got. Looks like a tough, gritty guy. We'll find out once he actually steps into the cage.
Trains out of Team Felony and Guardian Jiu-Jitsu. Describes his fighting style as Jiu-Jitsu and Sambo, something you don't see very often from somebody not named The Last Emperor or Olin Tektara.
He says that he knows his opponent is an excellent grappler. I don't know if he's aware that his opponent is also an excellent striker. Should be a good fight between these two.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the sixth fight of the evening in the welterweight division. Introducing first in the blue corner, with one win and one loss, fighting out of Drysdale Hyena, here is Milan Zerjal. And his opponent fighting out of the red corner from MMA, Team Felony Fighter, debuting tonight from Las Vegas, Nevada, this is Justin Calhoun. Your ref in charge, John Quinn.
We're going over the rules in the dressing room. Obey my instructions at all times. Let's touch gloves and put on a show.
Three two-minute rounds here at the Tough Enough Fighting Championship.
Calhoun looks like he could be Zerjal's older brother.
They look very similar. Milan Zerjal is wearing the straight black trunks with the red lettering. Justin Calhoun is wearing the black and the white.
Zerjal working his hands early. Saw Calhoun open up with the low kick.
And one thing that really impressed me about Zerjal last time we saw him fight is that he's so young in his fighting career, but he looks so composed.
That's what happens when you fight three times in 6 weeks. Zerjal pressing into the cage.
Right in front of the broadcast booth, determined to bleed on us again.
It's inevitable. Just get ready for it. Calhoun has the underhook.
Zerjal gets on top.
All in the half guard right now.
So
Zhao working the cross face, trying to create some room, deliver some damage. Calhoun doing a good job of overhooking on that right side to control the posture.
The cross face is legal, but no elbows in amateur MMA.
Zhao finally gets his arms free.
Goes with the cross face again.
Yeah, looking to posture up and do some damage from top.
May not finish the fight, but that's a very uncomfortable position to be in.
Zhao trying to create that distance. Find some space to throw some punches there.
Very high in that half mount, and then, yes, sliding out to side control. More of a north-south now.
Got an arm looking
Yeah, working on that arm.
Going for an arm bar.
The arm bar. It's going to be tough. He's up against the cage. He doesn't have much room to lean back, but he's looking at the excellent work of the feet to free the arm.
20 seconds
left. Three defenses, and that's it.
That's it. Melanzer Zhao training with Robert Drysdale pays off. You see his corner over there, including Mark Beecher, giving the big thumbs up right away. And first round victory for Melanzer Zhao. Calhoun looked like he wasn't sure if he was going to tap for a moment there, sort of patted once and then stopped. But the referee said, nope, that arm was extended. I think that was an appropriate stoppage, if you could even call it that. I think that was officially going to be ruled a tap out, don't you?
Yeah, absolutely. Melanzer Zhao didn't know if he was going to have the room. Obviously, he was right here in front of our broadcast booth. His back was up against the cage. But look at the excellent work as he puts his left leg on the arm there,
right there
to break the defenses. That is outstanding technique from a man just three fights into his amateur career. And we did get one tap on the leg there. That arm was fully extended. Justin Calhoun had no choice but to tap. Excellent performance again by Melanzer Zhao. I'm impressed by this kid early in his career.
Yeah, I am really impressed by him. Even in his last fight that he ended up not winning, a very close fight, showed a tremendous amount of heart. This is well done again by Melanzer Zhao. And this fight, 3 weeks out, he knew that he was going to take it.
21 years old, a lot of potential there, a lot of potential. Training with a great camp, another great showing by Melanzer Zhao.
Ladies and gentlemen, after a minute 43 into the first round, your winner by armbar, the blue corner, Melanzer Zhao.
One of the best things about Tough Enough is finding future stars of MMA. That may very well be one of them. Melanzer Zhao, expect to hear that name more. There he is at this corner. We're coming back to the Orleans. We've got more fights on the way. In fact, a lot of them. Thanks for tuning in tonight.